Welcome to Precision Gears, bringing involuted parametric gears to Blender. The download links are down in the description. So head on over to makertales.com and then click into the download section. Here's a shameless little plug to my new course, and I really suggest you go and check out that pre-sale before it runs out. In the download section, you'll get a link that will take you to the Gumroad page of Precision Gears. Now, yes, it is a paid add-on, but don't worry, there is a free version, and I'll tell you all about it in just a moment. I did ask you over in the YouTube community how much you'd be willing to pay for something like this. You told me under 10 bucks. So here you can put in 8 and click I want this, and that will work. But if you want to support more precision add-ons in the future and further development on this one, I'd love it if you could give me 15, because quality add-on development is surprisingly expensive. Speaking of which, this is technically still in beta for two main reasons. One is there's a lot more coming out in the next month or so, plus even more after that. All of this here has already been implemented, and I haven't added the presets just yet. And the main reason why is because I don't know really what presets to add. I don't know if you want them from a catalog. I don't know if you want them to be 3D printing specific. So go and let me know over in the Precision Gears channel, over in the Discord, by clicking here right there. Now, as for this free version, you get it by clicking right here, which will take you to the Precision Gears Lite. This version lets you make just a spur gear, which is the most used gear out there, so it's still extremely useful, and it's completely parametric just like the other version. So all you have to do is put in a 0 here, click I want this, and that's going to give you it for free. Now, either way, they're both going to give you a zip file, so let's go get that installed. Now, heading back to Blender, it's pretty simple to install. Just go to Edit, Preferences, go to Addon, then Install, double-click that zip file that downloaded, turn it on, and remember you can search it right there, and it's that simple to get this installed. Now, just before we go and make some gears in Blender, I need to be perfectly clear that I'm not going to show you how gears work in this one video, because that would be far too much to cover. But I will be making it, and it'll be linked in the card or down in the description once it's out. With that now said, let's go and make some gears in Blender. With Precision Gears now installed, it's under the Add menu, so Shift-A, go to Mesh, go all the way down, and you'll see Precision Gears. There is the Rack, Spur, Internal, Bevel, and Worm. We're going to start with the Rack one. Now, do keep in mind that the defaults and the presets are non-existent right this minute, because I need your help, because I don't know if I should do them to a catalog or if it should make them for 3D printing or what. So let me know down in the description. There is a link to help me out right there. The best place would be over in the Discord. So now that we've made this, let's go and change this up in some way. Now, you didn't have a dialog box that came up when we first made this. That's because this is driven by its own object properties. That's right, this is parametric as can be within Blender. You can change this on the fly. I'm going to go for a 1.5 millimeter module. Just know that that's usually about the smallest you can go for 3D printing. Then let's go for a width of 10. Let's go for a height of 10. I'm also going to change this to cavity. I know some of you don't like it, but I'm sorry. It's just easier to see. So let's say right here, this is a preset that I wanted to keep. All you have to do is click right here. We'll name this as test one, and we'll click OK. So if you wanted to make another one, I'm just going to go and move the 3D cursor on the X. We're going to create a new rack gear, and then I want to change this preset over to test. And there you have it. Now, we have a rack, and I want a pinion to go with it. So you might think, okay, well, I'll go over here, let's put in the spur gear, and then I'll be able to change this on the presets. No, because there's a much simpler way to make this work. All you have to do is duplicate this, move it out, and just say, hey, if this is a rack, I want this to be a spur. And lo and behold, you now have a spur gear to go with your rack gear. Now, this spur gear is looking a little bit plain right this minute, so let's go and add some extra stuff to it. Now, it's all down in here, and there's a lot to it, so we'll take this nice and slow. So we'll start with the extrusion. Right this minute, it's on bottom and top. I'll do an extrusion of 5. You might not see it because it's down on the bottom here, because we can do it on the bottom and the top, so I'll just go just for the top. Now here, I'm going to give it a radius of 5. We could put down the resolution all the way down to 6 to get a hex nut of some sort if you really want, but I'll go for 64 and leave that there. Okay, now I want a bore. In other words, a hole in the top of it of some sort. Now there's lots of different types of holes that you can do. We've got the cross, the round subtract, the round add, and the polygon. Let's go cross, nice and simple. It's right there, very easy to understand. We have the round subtract. This one's a little bit harder to understand. Let's put that to a radius of 3. Let's give this a resolution of 50, and then let's give this scalar a little bit more size. Let's move the position, and now you can see where this comes from. Now, you know that these usually need a set screw, and there is a set screw. Right here, we have the set screw. We'll turn it on by just turning this to number 1, and you'll see that it's teeny tiny right down there. If you don't see it, click preview, and you'll get a preview of the cutter. So there it is. So we'll make this nice and big. Now let's go for 1.5 radius. The offset go up. Now this isn't linked up to the extrusion because you can get set screws in the gears themselves sometimes. Now you might see that things go a little bit weird sometimes, like that right there. That's because it is on the fast one. If you want to fix that, just go to exact and that will usually fix it. Now I'll stick with the fast because it'll be working just fine once I change the angle over here to 90, and there we have it working beautifully and perfectly. Okay, so we've got that there. Let me show you that on the bore, you can also mirror it. You can also get a preview of it. Now, on top of that, we also have the round add. Now, this one's a little bit different. This is what some of you would call a key. So we're going to go here, change the set screw to off. We're going to change this to a round add, and now we're just going to make the scalar a lot smaller, and there we have a nice little key one. We'll also move the position in a little bit, and there we have it. Okay, so now that we have that, I want to create an internal gear for this gear here. So Shift D, move this on the X all the way that way, and now, as you already know, all we have to go is go to type and change that to internal, change the teeth amount, let's go for 60, and it's that simple to do that. So now we have our rack and pinion. We also have our internal gear and our gear to go and mesh together. Now, just before I show you how much deeper this gets, I also just want to cover quickly how to remove a preset. So if we had a preset of that test one, all we have to do is click delete, and that is that preset now done. Okay, so we have all of these right here. I've decided that I actually wanted all of these to be helical gears instead. So I'm going to copy them all out, go down here, you see where it says helix angle, I'm going to put in 15 there, I'm going to hold down Alt and then hit Enter, and lo and behold, they now all have a helix angle to them. Now, you know what, it wasn't a helix angle that I wanted to do, I actually wanted to herringbone all of these. So now that they already have a helix angle to them, all I have to do is hold down Alt and click herringbone, and now they're all going to be herringboned instead. As you can see, this is extremely powerful and super flexible. Now, just before we jump into the bevel and the worm gear, I just want to quickly show you the settings a little bit, not really showing you what exactly they're for and what they do, but just where they are and sort of a little synopsis of what they do. So we've got the module, which is sort of the tooth size. Then we've got the height, which is pretty self-explanatory. The pressure angle, which is this right here. It gets a little bit more complicated on that one. And then we've got the complexity of it. This is basically just the amount of vertices on the teeth themselves. And then we've got the shift, which sort of shifts it all. I'm just going to set this back to 0. And then we've got the head, which you can see the head. It's very easy to break this, by the way. So you've got to keep to real numbers and then things will not break. So we'll just reset that to the default value there. Then we've also got the clearance. I'm going to set this to 0. And this technically right here is what would be called your standard gear. The ones that don't have any clearance whatsoever, and it's just straight up the gear itself. So usually for 3D printing, these don't work absolutely perfectly. You need just a little bit of a give to them. So that there is the settings. There's a whole bunch more to it, but let's go and move on to the bevel gear. In fact, I'm going to use this gear because it works best to create bevel gears with not that much clearance and stuff like that. So I'm just going to grab this. We're going to move this over to bevel, and lo and behold, there it is. Now it might be a little bit broken here. I'm going to put this back to 1.5, and then I'm going to increase this up to 25, and there we have a lovely bevel gear right there. Now, bevel gears are very interesting because you can get quite interesting shapes with them. So I'll duplicate this out, move this out on the X. We're going to add maybe 50 teeth to it instead. So it goes out like this, and then we can start working with the pitch angle. So with the pitch angle, we can go really quite far with this. Let's go all the way down to 60, see what happens. So now we've got a 60 degree pitch angle there. Let's duplicate this out on the X, then let's rotate this on the Y by 90 in the other direction. So if we wanted this to mesh with that and be a 90 degree, well, we know that that's 60. So this one here needs to be a pitch of 30. So we'll put that to 30 right there. And then we can put this all the way down to maybe 10. Ooh, 10's a bit low. Let's go down to 20. So now we know that this one has 50. Let's make this 25. So if we move this to 25, you can just see how flexible this is. I just love it. So we move this here, move this like that. So now we know that that there is a 90 degree meshing right this minute. It is so powerful. Now, a couple of extra little features that the other ones don't have because they don't need it is the nice little tooth cleanup right here. So we got tooth trimming. And now let's go on to the slightly more complicated one, which is the worm gear. So I'm going to duplicate this one, move this out this way. And now let's go to the worm gear. Now, full open honesty here, I'm still learning worm gear, so I could be getting things completely wrong here, but they are very interesting. And for those of you that understand them, there it's all here. So we'll go to worm gear. I'm going to put this all the way down to 3 teeth. I'm then going to increase the diameter of this by quite some amount. I'm also going to increase the height of this. Then I'm also going to increase the helix steps to maybe about 50. There we go. Things are starting to come together there. So we've got that. That's looking good. So let's just go and change that extrusion radius, the top and bottom, increase the radius of this as well. And then we have a lovely worm gear. Oops, I made the radius nothing there. That's not what I meant to do. Let's make that radius out. There we have it. So we've got that right there. You could add a set screw to this. You can do anything you want. So if we had a gear to this, right this minute, we do not have worm wheel gears. I would love to implement them, but my development fund has run dry for that, but in the future, I really am planning to add that. So right this minute, you would have to get yourself probably this worm gear right here. So Shift D, move this out a little bit this way. We would then change this over to a spur gear. We would probably add the teeth that we're wanting. Let's go for 25. Let's add that height back to 10. And then we would have to figure out the angle that you'd need to pitch this at. So maybe it's an angle of 25 or 20 more around there. Then we can rotate this on the X, go by 90, and then we can just move this all the way to here somewhere. Then we'll just move this out this way like that. And then it's going to be a little bit of trial and error right this minute, but there are equations for this. And like I just said, in the future, I really am planning to get this to work once I have some more funding to be able to put in some more money into the development of this. So from here, just to show you just quite how parametric this is, I've just decided that, you know what, all of these here are all wrong. I needed to have a different module, so I'm going to duplicate this out, move this on the X, and be careful, these are pretty high mesh things sometimes. And I wanted the module to be 2. So put in 2, hold down Alt, hit Enter, and now all of those are going to change to have a module of 2. I hope you see just how powerful this really is. It is incredible what you can do with this. Now, something that works absolutely brilliantly with this is my other add-on, which is Outline to SVG. So you can create all sorts of gears that you're wanting to use for laser cutting or CNCing or whatever. You can then select the gear itself, use Outline to SVG. The link is down in the description, completely for free. Put it where it is you wanted to export and then hit that export. And now you have an SVG outline of this for use in CNC, for use in laser cutting, you name it, you can do it. Now, I do have a little bit extra to show you, but this is of what's about to come and it's not live just yet, but the plan is for it to be live probably in the next few weeks. So a few things coming up are better geometry and pre-creased edges so that they are more compatible with subdivision modifiers and bevel modifiers, a whole bunch of teeth modification, including tapering, tapering offsets, tip relief resolution, crowning, end relief, undercutting, And all of those put together give you an endless world of new possibilities. And all that there is still just the start of it. Considering you've made it this far along the video, I might as well tell you that I'm even developing an animation part where we'll be able to make gear chains to make them all work together, but that is still in heavy development, and we'll see how I get with there. So sign up for some updates over to my newsletter that's also linked down in the description. A huge thank you to my patrons. Without you, I would not have been able to make this add-on whatsoever. I'm just so happy that I'm able to make it as available as possible for all the makers out there like yourself. And if you're enjoying what I'm making here and you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. And don't forget that we have a Discord, and that's linked down in the description. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.